What's up, guys? It's been about a week since we made our plates. We're gonna see the results. We're gonna see if everything came out good. I'm expecting some good results, so let's go dive into it. I haven't looked yet. So last time we inoculated a few plates, and we also did some secret plates in the background. Just to surprise you guys today, because they're pretty cool, and I can see just from looking over at the table over there that they came out pretty good. So let's go dive into the flow hood. I'm gonna put some gloves on and grab some ISO 70%. I like to spray again just for good measure. We're just gonna look at our last inoculations. We're gonna look for any signs of contamination, which would be pretty much anything that's not white for these species anyway. You can actually see some classic lion's mane. I'm gonna pull you guys in right here. Let's see. There's little, looks like little comets. Across pretty much every plate. See that? So we inoculated with a liquid culture for this, and it ran around the corners as a liquid does, and you can see all the ends are up on the sides. And that all came from this. So we have all of this mycelium about to grow out in these cups, on these dishes because of this. And we still have so much left because we're only putting a few drops on each one. Next up is the, what we call the sidewalk reishi. The mycelium in here is very, very thin. You can tell it all colonized pretty well, especially these plates. Ah, here we go. So this is why we do different color plates. Is on these plates, you can see, you can just barely see the mycelium there coming out from that point. But it's so much more obvious. It's so much more obvious on a blue plate. How incredible that is. And all the light there that's coming off of there, that's the mycelium that we placed from the original plate right here. Let's see if we can find. See, here's multiple examples of the same thing. These plates are completely clean. You can tell because the pattern is uninterrupted. Remember, these plates were plain blue, and now they're like starting to turn white from the inoculation point. So cool. And this took only a week. So these plates would actually be good to move on to other plates or to move on to like a liquid culture. This one is outstanding. The colors, the texture, it's starting to build that skin. Really amazing. And so like these plates are just as amazing, but they're not visually appealing because you can't really see. You can see the mycelium, but it doesn't pop. And this is why we use food dye sometimes, just so we can get a better look. Kind of wish I did this one on a blue plate. So I inoculated from two points, and they're going to converge together and collect their own nutrients, but then they'll share it because they're all the same strain. They're all the same variety. You can see on one side, right there. One, the other side is the other, and they're converging together. And it looks just like two of these. So if you were to line these up, once they touch, they'll just combine together. This is pretty cool because we were saying in the last video that the sidewalk reishi might have been dirty, and we actually got two contams right here. But the rest of these plates, they're beautiful, they're clean, and we get to take something that we found locally just around the block and grow it out again and use its medicinal properties for teas and whatnot. But I mentioned contamination, so there was some, it looks like, it could be cobweb mold, but I don't concern myself too much about what the contamination is because there could be, it could be any number of things. The whole point, like we don't want any contamination at all. So if you see it, you can pretty much either isolate it from that, from this plate, isolate what you want from the plate, or just toss it. And I'm going to just toss these because we already have clean plates. This is why you do a lot of them. And then it saves you a lot of time. Because if we only did this plate and this was dirty, we'd have to isolate it. Wait another week or so. But we get to just keep moving forward and toss out what we don't want. So this is, you can see, this might not be contamination, but I don't like how the mycelium on the edge is flaring out like that. It's like standing straight up. That could just be the really vigorous mycelium looking for nutrient, but there's nutrient right in front of it, so it doesn't really have a reason to do that. That's a little suspicious to me, especially when I look at this other plate and I see a similar looking contamination. A little hard to see, but you can see there's like some hairs standing straight up on there. Also, the two sides, the two ends of the hairs have kind of like microscopic like beads on them, and mycelium do not do that. They're more like the white here, very uniform. The texture changes here, so that tells me that contamination got in there and is interrupting the growth. We don't want that, so we're just going to toss it out. It's all good. The contamination will not leave the petri dish, so you can handle it pretty easily, and just toss the dish out when you're done. And you can even see there's like a discoloration starting here. So like the white mycelium is here, and then you see like a slightly darker color emanating from here. They both came from this inoculation point, so it came from the dirty culture, but because the contamination is more vigorous, it jumped out in front and started claiming all of the nutrient in front of it, unfortunately. But you know, it doesn't matter. That's how we do a lot of transfers at once. This was the original cup. See, it's very, you can tell it's been there for a while. You can see the skin's really thick. Yeah. So we're going to move on to the Ganoderma sinense. Typically reishi is like a candy corn candy corn flavor. I wish. Candy corn colored kind of theme. And this one is just black and white. Really cool to see once it's fully grown out. This is what we originally took from. You can see some metabolites are starting to form in there because we opened the cup, we let some air in there, so now it's gonna try to fruit, more than likely. That cup's been closed for a long time. So we just kind of activated the mycelium and now they're gonna try to fruit. And you can see, skimming all these plates, are clean, but the growth is slower than the sidewalk ratio. So this is what we have so far. And I say it's clean because after looking at all the plates, and this one came from grain. After looking at all the plates, the growth is pretty uniform. There aren't any jumping ahead of any others. You can see they're coming out from different points here, one from there. Like from each tip of that triangle, they're shooting out. In another week, it's going to look more like a cone on each one of those ends. You can kind of see that in this one. Condensation inside of your petri dishes is totally fine. It won't really do anything. If anything, it's good for it. It kind of creates like a microbiome where the water is going to get recycled. It won't really interrupt what the mycelium are doing as long as the original inoculation is like pretty solid. And you can see these guys are very established. It looks like a little mountain. There's like an avalanche coming off the base of each mountain, and it's the avalanche is the mycelium. So cool. Should do some time lapses of these. And even beyond like that denser white, you can see there's a finer bit of mycelium that's kind of scouting ahead. Yeah. Awesome. So those look good. We're going to move on to our, we had a local found lion's mane that I foraged from a dog park in Alexandria, Virginia. So I'm going to take a quick peek at these. All right, so it looks like all of these came out pretty good. Lion's mane is pretty slow, especially on agar. And you can see it's even slower than the Ganoderma, the sinensis that we have. You can see it just barely is on the plate so far. It's just barely on the plate, but it is established. That's all that matters. See, they're all pretty uniform. They've all made about the same progress. You can see there's no other colors, there's no other patterns. There's nothing else growing on the dish. These all look great. We even have a double inoculation. They haven't quite met each other yet, but they will pretty soon. And our last one, this one fell off in the corner, but it's still very clean. A lot of condensation in there. I think this one was on top. And yeah. Super clean plates. Nothing extra in those plates. That's always what you want to aim for. Keep your contamination under like 5%. That's what I try to do. All right, so this is the big one. So we actually had some cordyceps actually finish fruiting. Like the stroma produced the ascospores. And so we dabbed some on these plates. And it looks like it actually germinated. Like we have some crazy growth. So what this is actually a albino cordyceps. And you can see the mycelium are jumping off inoculation points. But what's cool is like on this plate in the middle, that's the clone, but the surrounding colonies, these are actually spore germinations. So we're gonna take from these and not the clone. I just wanted to see how they would look growing next to each other. And you can see because because there's a germination, it's a lot more dense because there's a lot of spores germinating and they're all fighting for that mycelium. It's less dense, or it's more dense than that single colony coming from here, the clone. See, these are all dabs of the stroma. Here you can see the entire stroma with the spores on this tip, just dabbed all through there. And you can see all those little like micro colonies, like they look like little explosions. Each one of those is a spore germination. Every single one. So I'm gonna let those grow out and I'm gonna try to like isolate them into different colonies. And this is just a straight plate of all like dabbing the spores around, and they all took off so easily. Amazing. This is the first time I've ever done this. I was just playing around with it and it seems to have worked out like really well. So we're going to have albino cordyceps here probably. Yeah, really impressed with this one. This is very dense. And I love how you can see the difference in the growth. Like, the clone is nowhere near as dense as the fresh germination of spores. And I think that'll become a lot more evident as they grow bigger. Pretty awesome. In anticipation of our mycelium fully colonizing the plates, or getting to the point of fully colonizing the plates, we're going to start looking into prepping our grain to make grain spawn. And all grain spawn is mycelium that have colonized grain. And once they colonize that, they're pretty much living on top of an energy source that they can use to colonize other things. And then we're going to use that to colonize substrate before we fruit. All right, guys, yo, I'm super hype actually after like really taking the time to look at the footage again and just look at the different growth. Like, you can really see the mycelium popping. And look, that's a week of growth. It's very fast. This has been Shay from Microdex Mushrooms over in the PCT labs in Washington, D.C. I will see you guys later. Hey, Microdex here. If you guys want to support the channel and save some money on some plant and fungi supplies, go and check out the Plant Cell Technology Store and use the code MICRODEX to save 10%.